We want to find the derivative of f of x equals 2x square root x plus 4 divided by x squared square root x, and then find f prime of 1. Well, before we find our derivative, we need to recognize two things. First, we need to rewrite the square roots using rational exponents, and then second, we need to rewrite these terms so we have x raised to some power, so we can apply the power rule of differentiation. Let's first write the square roots using rational exponents. To review, if we have the nth root of a to the m, this is equal to a raised to the power of m divided by n. So using rational exponents, the denominator is the index, and the numerator is the exponent. Because these are square roots, the index is 2, and this is x, meaning this is x to the first, and so is this. So we can write the square root of x as x to the 1/2. So the original function can be written as f of x equals, instead of 2x square root x, we can write this as 2x times x to the 1/2. Remember, this x here would also have an exponent of 1, plus 4 divided by x squared, again, times x to the 1/2. Now let's go ahead and find these products involving x. When multiplying and the bases are the same, we add the exponents. So we'd have f of x equals 2x to the power of 1 plus 1/2 is 1.5, or 3/2, plus 4 divided by x to the power of 2 plus 1/2, that would be 2.5, or 5/2. So we have x to the 5/2 in the denominator. So this term looks good. But to apply the power rule of differentiation, we need to rewrite this term here using negative exponents. To review this property, if we have 1 divided by a raised to the power of m, we can rewrite it as a raised to the power of negative m. So if this crosses the fraction bar, it's going to change the sign of the exponent. So if we move this up to the numerator, it's going to change the sign of the exponent to negative 5/2. So now we have f of x equals 2x to the 3/2 plus 4x to the negative 5/2. And now finally we can find the derivative using our power rule of differentiation. Let's go ahead and do that. F prime of x is going to be equal to 2 times the derivative of x to the 3/2. So we'll have 2 times the exponent of 3/2 times x to the power of 3/2 minus 1 plus 4 times the exponent of negative 5/2 times x to the power of negative 5/2 minus 1. So this is our derivative function, but now we need to simplify this. This is 2 over 1, so these 2's simplify nicely. So our first term would be 3 x to the power of 3/2 minus 1, or 3/2 minus 2/2, that's 1/2. Here the 4 and the 2 simplify. This simplifies to 1, this simplifies to 2. So we have plus negative 10, or minus 10, x to the power of negative 5/2 minus 1, or negative 5/2 minus 2/2, would be negative 7/2. Let's go ahead and rewrite the second term using a positive exponent. So again, we can think of this as being over 1. If we move this down to the denominator, it's going to change the sign of the exponent. So we'd have f prime of x equals 3x to the 1/2 minus 10 divided by x to the power of 7/2. Now this would be our derivative using rational exponents, but I also want to show how to rewrite this using square roots, since the original function was given using square roots. We would have f prime of x equals, well, x to the 1/2 is the same as the square root of x. This would be 3 square root of x. Notice how the index is 2 because we have a square root, that's the denominator, and the exponent on this x is 1, which is the numerator. Then we'd have minus 10, and then for x to the 7/2, that's a little tricky. 7/2 is the same as 3.5, so we can write this as 3 plus 1/2. Which means if we have x to the 7/2, we could rewrite this as x to the third times x to the 1/2. Remember, when multiplying, we add the exponents. which means we can write x to the 7 halves as x to the third times the square root of x. So again, depending on the text or the instructor, you may be able to leave your derivative function in this form here, but if we need the derivative using square roots, it would be in this form here. The second part of this question asks us to find f prime of 1, which will give us the slope of the tangent line when x equals 1. Let's find this on the next slide. So to find f prime of 1, we'll substitute 1 for x into the derivative function. Well, the square root of 1 is equal to 1, so we just have 3 minus, this would be 10 divided by 1, or just 10. So f prime of 1 is equal to negative 7, which again would be the slope of the tangent line when x equals 1. Let's go ahead and verify this graphically. The red graph is the graph of our function. Notice when x equals 1, we'd be at this point here on the function. The blue line would be the tangent line when x equals 1. And since f prime of 1 is equal to negative 7, the slope of this blue tangent line is negative 7. I hope you found this helpful.